Hey everyone, today I want to quickly walk you through a failover scenario which has raised some questions from several customers. And one of the questions that comes in for this particular failure scenario is why vSphere HA is reporting that there aren't sufficient resources to fail over a certain number of virtual machines or a given virtual machine. Let me paint the picture for you first. In this particular scenario, we have a vSphere stretch cluster and a vSAN stretch cluster as well, and we have a virtual machine running inside B. Now, this virtual machine that is running inside B, from a data perspective, only has its data stored inside B as well. So the data is not replicated between side A and side B. From a vSAN perspective, you can simply do this by creating a policy. So you create a policy that states that the data only needs to reside inside B and assign the policy to that particular virtual machine. On top of that, what a lot of customers actually end up doing is also creating a DRS or a cluster rule that states that the virtual machine always needs to reside on one of the hosts that is part of side B as well. Now, the question then of course comes, what happens during a failure? What if something happens to the network in between the locations, in between side A and side B, and side A is actually partitioned from side B, or side B is partitioned from side A, depending, of course, on which side you are sitting and how you look at the particular situation. In this particular scenario, what is going to happen? And this is something that a lot of customers were actually surprised about. But in this particular scenario, when this happened, what you will end up seeing in vCenter server is these error messages reporting that the restart of a particular virtual machine has failed and that not enough resources are available in the environment for restarting the virtual machine. And you may wonder why that is. Well, as I mentioned, in this particular case, the host in side A are going to try to restart the virtual machine that is part of side B. However, the hosts in side A do not have access to the virtual machine components, to the data itself, which is stored on the vSAN data store that resides in side B. Of course, that is because the network has failed in between those two locations. Now, that then still by itself doesn't really explain why it is trying to restart the virtual machine when there actually is also a DRS rule in place. Well, the reason for it is fairly straightforward. Well, there are a couple of things happening at this particular point in time. First of all, site A is reporting that there aren't enough resources available to restart the virtual machine itself. It doesn't necessarily say that it doesn't have enough resources available. It just says that in general, there aren't enough resources available. And in this particular case, it's actually referring to the fact that the hosts in site A can't instruct any of the hosts in side B to restart the virtual machine itself. Now, the other thing, of course, is that you may be wondering why on earth is side A even trying to restart the virtual machine, which is still up and running in side B. And this is simply because of the reason that the hosts in side A don't know what has happened to the hosts in side B. As there's a partition, from a networking perspective, site A is not able to communicate to any of the hosts in site B any other way around. So it simply doesn't know what has happened, and it's going to assume that the hosts have completely failed, and therefore it will try, or at least notify the fact that the virtual machine probably was impacted by a failure and cannot be restarted. As you can imagine, when the partition is lifted, what is going to happen is that the hosts in site A are going to realize that the virtual machine is still up and running, and of course those error messages will disappear again. And with that, hopefully I've been able to explain to you why this particular scenario happens and why HA actually reports that it's trying to restart a particular virtual machine while that may not even make sense, or it doesn't appear to make sense. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.